Distinguished invitees, my dear friends. Kanchana invited me about 2 weeks, 3 weeks ago for this forum and told me all about it. And then she also sent me a speech that I was to deliver to you, all of you, 2 or 3 days ago. I got it all placed in my placement cards, but after having seen what has been done and what you all have done, I thought I will, instead of the speech that has been prepared for me, I will tell you a story. People do tell me that I'm good at telling stories. Today is a different story that I want to tell you. As my brief history was put on the screen, so that I'm a chartered accountant by profession. I qualified as a chartered accountant in 1976. And when I qualified, we had a batch of 72 who started off, and we were one of those batches where a large number of people got through. I think it was a very good batch. And then, immediately after we qualified, by 1977, about 40% of my batchmates had left Sri Lanka. They were working outside Sri Lanka. Then came 1983, about another 10% worked outside Sri Lanka. Then came 1989, perhaps about another 20% worked out of Sri Lanka. So little by little, the batch got smaller and smaller. Our get-togethers were not all that fantastic because we could only have small numbers. And that was the progress that we made in Sri Lanka during that period. During the last several years, I think the conditions have changed materially. Today, I think we're not talking about working outside Sri Lanka. We're talking about work in Sri Lanka. A huge paradigm shift has taken place in our country. And I think we all need to be conscious of that. We all need to focus, where do we go beyond that? I think we have reached a very important milestone in our history. We have reached a position where today, no longer are we talking about finding ways and means of desperately going out, but people who are qualified can easily contribute towards our country. I became the governor in 2006, and at that time, one of the problems that the central bank was facing was that when we send people outside Sri Lanka to study, do their postgraduate, do PhDs, very few of them come back. So that was a dilemma that we faced, but we still continue to do so. We said, let us train people, let us put people to absorb new ideas, and then we will see what happens. Today, 7 years later, I believe only one has not come back to the country. Everyone else who studied abroad, brilliant people, have come back and they are serving Sri Lanka. So again, a massive change in our country. Another story that I heard a few days ago was that when you want to get a nice jacket stitched, I'm told that there are South Indian tailors who are here who do that for you, much cheaper than what the Sri Lankan tailors do. I think Kanchana herself is attired in those beautiful jackets, which she told me that she has got stitched from the South Indian tailors in Vellavatta. And I also know that there are barbers who are here, coconut pluckers who are here, people who are here at the time of harvesting. Again, new people coming to serve Sri Lanka, work in Sri Lanka, because the conditions have changed. Then we also have people who come and work in Sri Lanka today, professional people. I remember during the last 6 months, we have been on many tours to various parts of the world, and people come and talk to us and say, How do we come and work in Sri Lanka now? What are the avenues that are available? A completely different picture from what we have seen in the past. I think we are all convinced that there are opportunities for Sri Lankans who have been abroad, for outside foreigners who have been abroad to come and work in Sri Lanka and contribute to our economy. Kanchana showed how we have worked on 6 hubs, the 5 hubs that have been enumerated in the Mahinda Chintana, the knowledge hub, the commercial hub, the energy, maritime, and aviation, coupled with the tourism hub, needs people who can contribute on a continuous basis. We also have to bring in fresh ideas from outside. We also have to have people who can work with the rest of the world. And I think we are now on that new chapter, and we all have to refocus on how we are going to do business in the future, how we are going to absorb all these new people who would also like to come. About a year ago, I was in Melbourne, and there was a forum of Sri Lankan Australians who were there, and several said that they would like to come back. But some said, we'd like to come back, and we need to be assured of certain positions. Now, that's an area where we'll have to be fairly conscious as to how we are going to deal with that. I think the market is open. The employment opportunities are there, business opportunities are there. But I think they'll need to work out their own space when they come into Sri Lanka. There are some who have been at the central bank, even through all the turmoil that this country went through. Some of us have been in this country. We have never worked outside. We have worked diligently for this country for the last so many years. We are proud of that. At the same time, we are open. We want others also to come in. So when the others come in, naturally, there will be new spaces that need to be created for them. And some need to create their space by themselves as well. So new business ventures could be promoted. New ideas will have to be fertilized in order to take forward the concept. But all that will be up to those who wish to come into Sri Lanka. But we need to welcome them. And that is what is important. There are some who left Sri Lanka because it was difficult to work here. Because some who left Sri Lanka because they were frightened. There were some who thought they could have better pastures. For whatever reason that they have gone, when they do come back, they must be welcomed, they must be helped, they must also be allowed to absorb well into our culture and into our systems. So an initiative such as what the 13 of you have launched today is an interesting one, an important one. It tells the rest of the world that we are open to them. It tells the rest of the world about Sri Lanka, as to what Sri Lanka could offer to them when they do come into Sri Lanka. And I would like to commend that effort in a very, very strong manner, because I think it is a vital cog in this whole concept of getting people to contribute to Sri Lanka. We have to develop and improve our productivity levels in our country. One of the best ways in which we could ensure that we can have low inflation is by improving productivity. We have identified that on many occasions in our annual reports, as well as in various other communications that we have done. But we need to take that very seriously. We know that when Sri Lankans go outside, they become a lot more productive than when they are here. Some have that in them, but they need to come back and practice it in Sri Lanka as well. So we are hoping that this initiative that these young people have taken would provide a new impetus to the concept of productivity, which we need to nurture so that Sri Lanka will have low inflation, sound macro fundamentals, which are the areas that we are mostly concerned about and conscious of. So let me wish this effort all success. Let me also hope that this initiative will pave the way for Sri Lankans who have left our country at different times to come back, to get involved in the activities of our nation, and to promote the country as well as ensure that our levels of productivity are improved, that our business practices are improved, our doing business indicators are improved, so that together we can move forward and realize the dreams that we have set ourselves and to continue to progress in our country. Thank you very much.